So, Driz ever, hold on. Where did I go? What is this? What is this? Where am I? Oh, there I am. So, Driz ever, it's so dark in here. And it just teemingly got super dark. Okay, hold on. Oh. Hush music. Where on earth? This is such a mess right now. So, yeah, like, I haven't been on in about a week or so. And then before that, I was lost for even longer than that. And there was, like, a couple weekends I took off. And it's all because I was thinking to myself, I'm like, I really don't have any content for you guys. So, it didn't make much sense for me to be on and then just like you guys were gonna like look at nothing. Let me turn my light on, okay? So you can see it. Show me, okay. So yeah, like it's just super dark and grim in here. It's not my camera. My camera's not the one that sucks. It's my lighting. Mail. I'm gonna call it fan mail. I got something else. Anybody want every plate? If you want it, you can. You can have it. Seriously. This is. Add a wish list in every plate. It makes it seem like it's like some kind of gift card for you. So this is the code you're gonna use for that. I'll include that in the chat a little bit later. Not really a giveaway. I mean, if you didn't get one of these, you'd love me, I guess. This, I don't like those pre-made meals or whatever, like the meals you make yourself, because there's so much waste involved, and it actually doesn't take. They're like, oh, it takes 30 minutes to cook and this, this, and that. I'm like, sure, but I can make better meals than they can come up with, and then usually I can't stand the meals that they come up with. It's like really bland. What is this about? Later on, I got a bunch of things to put in my recycling. I'm really thirsty. Oh, good. Got something. So yeah, I wasn't on for a long time. I was just like itching to do a stream. I really was. I just didn't know what content to do. And it was a little discouraging for me, to be honest, because I still haven't made affiliate yet. I'm lacking all the people, the things that I needed. There's a whole lot of crap going on in here. My house is under renovation. I'll show you those videos. I promise you, I'll show you those videos. And then you guys can understand what exactly had been going on here. So, all is well. Thanks, Daniel. I'm alive! Am I happy? Sort of. I had a good time at work. I can tell you that much. As far as everything else being better. Yeah. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. That's super cool. Anywho. Oh, this looks terrible. Anywho, so, I just realized I don't have my nose piercing yet. I look like crap. This white light makes everything so white. So yeah, I'll show you guys what's going on there soon. I guess I'm gonna turn the fan on so I can do my Just Dance. That's a routine to do. But first off, I gotta go clean this place up really quick. So.
Sometimes our hair needs a little vacation. That's where Batiste Dry Shampoo comes in.
I didn't do the demolition, okay? Like, I had guys come to do that. So. I don't know what you're talking about.
Embrace your flower.
Oh, wait. Did you see? Did you see the YouTube video or not? I'm not sure about that. I mean, because it just
with more than 15 different fragrances, Batiste has the perfect scent for you. Look now and find yours. Because study is better with play.
Oh, hi, cat. Samsung Galaxy so adorbs.
Ready to make the most of your school year? The ultra-large screen gets you closer to the action, whether you're studying, streaming, or gaming. Seamless syncing lets you hand off calls, videos, files, and more to other Galaxy devices, like your phone. The included S Pen gives you a super smooth experience. Plus, choose a vivid color that shows off your personal style.
Let's see how close I can get to him before he starts moving.
Terms and conditions apply.
I'm coming for you. I'm coming. Oh, there I am.
Last minute holiday shopping. There's so many gifts to choose from.
Well, yeah,
the shelves
yes.
at Marshall's are fully stocked right up until the big day. There's gonna be so many happy stockings. Sure. Fabulous brands.
Feel good prices at Marshall.
Well, aren't you a cutie pie? That's right. So yeah, today's just a documentation commentary day. Right now I'm doing my chat source. It's gonna be wild! Not really, I don't think so. It's gonna be what it's gonna be, okay? It's gonna be. Yep. So, I gotta clean this out, because I can't dance like this. And y'all can't even really see what I'm freaking doing. I'm probably gonna have to, like, close the door at some point. And I don't know why there's so much crap in here. Like, what kind of I need room in here to dance doesn't my dad understand? You can't just put a whole bunch of chairs in here and expect me to be happy. I also don't need that much room. Are you upset? Oh, you're a cutie. Me and my one viewer will get along just perfectly. Alright, so I gotta see what all I gotta clear out. I don't want that in view. Not if you're gonna watch me dance. Everything's just on the floor. Let me see if I have my hands. I think I have my hands. Okay, here we go. Okay. Alright, so let me, I guess, tune everything down. Tune slash turn everything down. You guys can see what I'm doing here. Flash Jenna! Do I have my camera on? Can you hear me fine? Is it okay? Anywho, so jumping back into the precision of what is what. Why is this showing again? Why is this not showing everything? Where is my phone? I guess my Chrome doesn't have anything on it. Alright. I'm not sure. Crap. Anybody remember what my password was? No thanks. Does anybody remember what my password was? Anywho, since today was all about this, I guess I'm just gonna go do this. I don't even know if this is the right account. No! Everything sucks right now. Okay. Screw this, I don't wanna log into YouTube. Fine, I'm not gonna log into YouTube. I'm just gonna go in from this. So, let's see. You guys can't really see it. Okay. So apparently, mine is not the first thing you'll see. It's still not the first thing you see. I don't know what you guys saw. I didn't like lose space in the house of remodeling. It's just that currently I'm in my office and then my dad starts moving stuff out away and I'm just like, do you not understand that I have to work in my office? You can't just throw shit in my office, dude. So I have no idea what happens in here when I'm at work. So, that's what that's about. Am I happy about it? Meh. I can be indifferent about it, I suppose. Oh my god! Somebody tell me something! Why? I'm trying to add so you can see what I'm doing in Chrome, but hold on, I guess
why doesn't every home in the U.S. have
it needs to have, like, whatever. I'm not paying for this, so sorry. It's not even showing what I wanted to show, but I'm just trying to get the audio to work on here. Nothing about what I'm trying to do. My house. I can't even find my videos. I don't know where YouTube loses me. You know, like, I put in my name and nothing comes up. See this? See this? You have to pay. You have to pay them. For other people to see you, by the way. See? I'm not even on here. There we go. I found me. Cool. Is this the right one? No, this is not the right one. It's not even the right one. And that, my friend, is exactly how your shit gets, like, lost on here. So here we go.
Hey, boys. I just got home. Guess what? They just did demo in my house. It's just the first day, day one. Let's see what it looks like. Okay, so there was a wall here, and now it's not there anymore. There's a fridge. There's just a big empty space right here.
Yeah, so that's my kitchen right now. This is how I'm showing it to y'all because, like, I can't be, like, wireless to go over there.
There's a pantry. The pantry is going on.
I wonder, do they make
wireless
headphones?
I'm not entirely sure what's going to go on here. It looks like some of the electrical still have to stay there. Not sure, but this is where the pantry was. Okay. Alright, ooh, yoy. Okay, never seen a naked before. Was it on? Was it on when we finished? Did it finish? I don't know. Oh my god. That's that. Okay. Did it finish? I don't know if it finished or not. Alright, so electric tools here.
Oh, that reminds me. I gotta go check up on that. You keep watching. I'll be right back.
Is it not open anymore? Hold on. I don't even know if it finished or not. It looks like they disrupted the cycle. I'm not sure. But it looks like there's like a bunch of... It looks like they disrupted the cycle. So, I'm a little upset about that. But they did get the demo done. I'm going to just finish the cycle here. I think I'm just going to do like a... Quick. What the? Okay, let's get it drain first. I guess that's what I have to do. Alright, so I'm gonna move this over here for now. Because they got all this demo they gotta take out. I'm not sure exactly how they're gonna go about doing that. There's a lot of stuff going on here. I don't know if this is whatever hours worth, but it's definitely good for day one. Why this cabinet is here, I'm not entirely sure. I'm not having it resurface. I can't see anything over here, guys. Can I turn on the light? Nope. Alright, so just a big pile right here. So the kitchen's gonna be over there. This is where it's gonna be. This is where this thing is. I'm basically moving the kitchen over there. And now that I'm looking at it, it looks kinda awkward. I don't think they can really move the fridge over some. Because there's an outlet there. But it would be kind of cool to have an outlet in the pantry. And tell them that they can keep that in there. Very interesting. Well, if that's the first thing first, I think that would be the water one. There's Red Bulls. Just sitting there. I can't really judge people by one, by day one. So far, it looks... like they did a lot of work. I mean, it's hard to tell at this point. Looks like they just kind of ripped everything apart. So, I'm not sure. Oh, but what I do know, I could like set a bug ball up in here. No. Yeah. can do that. Maybe? I throw those seedlings in there, though. Yeah. That's day one.
Alright, so it sounds like that just got done.
So, there's the pantry. The pantry is now gone.
Alright, so that was totally what it was. Like, totally.
Looks
that's
like
what it was.
Some of the electrical still have to stay there.
I wish I could just view what I have on my phone to you guys, like, perfectly.
Right.
But there's no way to really do that. Not without Facebook being on. So what I'm gonna do...
Okay, day one of the run.
Oh, it's too long.
Doesn't my cat look confused? Because I'm confused too. Look at this guy. He's just so confused. I know. It's just a big pile of rubble, man. I know it's just day one, but I was like, why? Why is it still here? Well, I guess I'm gonna figure that out soon. Like, it's kind of strange. Kind of strange to just have everything like this, you know? I guess it's like, I have no idea. Woo! Like, that was my kitchen. And that's like, these are the appliances she's keeping. We have removed the fur down. We have removed the cabinets all on one side, and the bottom on the other side, and the pantry is gone too. But the top, we're leaving for tomorrow.
Yep, so that's exactly what had happened. Am I happy about it? It's too easy. It's not too easy. It's too soon to tell if I should be upset about it or not, because it's literally just... the first day. So that's what I had to do. Yep. So, yeah. Easy is it. Easy to get day. See what he does. That's it. That's what he does.
Him. See? It's him. That's what he was doing.
I was in there. He's just like, what's up, man? And so, that's all as well right there. Like, after, promise me, it's amazing. Promise me. Okay. So that was that. I usually don't put anything in my coffee. And I put oat milk in it. And some of it has separated to the bottom and makes it look kind of disgusting. But this is coffee. Scientifically, this is coffee. So, let's see what's what around here. Alright, I guess I'm going to head out for a second. Have you guys watched something that I was, like, kind of shocked and appalled about?
$5,000 PC that costs $0. It's time to give you...
Oh no.
Historical cosmetics have a reputation for including, well, not exactly the most pleasant-sounding of ingredients. Thankfully, by the late 19th century, we're largely doing away with the lead and alum of previous centuries, and most of the ingredients for the recipes printed in home guides, such as this selection of hair treatments I collected from an 1880 Mali source, which I will be consulting in this video, are still available today. That burns. I'm curious to know, first and foremost, if these products work. But I'm also interested to investigate what these routine treatments can tell us about the lives of the people who used them, how much time it takes to make up these recipes, for example, and how much time it takes to apply the products, what effects they might have on the hair, if they lessen or add to maintenance time, all things that can give us a clue as to who might have been using them in their day-to-day lives, and why. But before we can test to see if these products actually work, we first need the products themselves. So, ready your drums and pipkins, because we have some Victorian potions to brew. So, we're going to start with the first recipe, which is a recipe for a solution to curl hair, because this one specifically requires sitting for 1 week. Many of the mixtures for curling the hair are injurious, but the recipe given below will be found to be harmless. We shall see about that, considering we are about to put such questionable chemicals as carbonate of potash, which is potassium carbonate, liquor of ammonia, and rectified spirit, which is a 95% alcohol solution, in my hair. First and foremost, for the purpose of this entire experiment, I have to go ahead and get a couple of Victorian measuring objects. Firstly, because a lot of these recipes give quantities in grams, which is not a quantity of measuring that we commonly use today. But the other thing is, a lot of measurements are given in ounces, which, yes, are imperial measures, and yes, I, as an American, am well-versed in the imperial measurement system. However, the current U.S. measurement system for ounces is actually a little bit different from the Victorian fluid ounce. So this little cylinder here has a measure both for fluid grams as well as fluid ounces from approximately the 1890s, so this would be the correct quantity of fluid ounces. For this recipe, we need dry salt of tartar, cochineal powdered, yes, that is in fact a highly potent natural dye, liquor of ammonia, essence of rose, glycerine, rectified spirit, and distilled water. So first on our list, we are told to measure out 1 gram of dry salt of tartar, which is carbonate of potash in parentheses, which in our modern day terms is potassium carbonate. There is a chemical warning on the front of this. Safety glasses and adequate ventilation. These are not, in fact, safety glasses. One half a dram of cochineal powder. If you don't know what cochineal is, it is an insect. They produce a crushed red, scarlet, purple dye. Okay, now we get into the liquid stuff. It is good that they had us do the powdery stuff first, so it doesn't all stick to the inside of the thing. However, we need to do 1 gram of liquor of ammonia. That burns. Oh, and it's funny. That's got to be a good sign, right? Next, essence of rose. Next is glycerine, of which we need 1/4 of an ounce. Okay, the rose oil has actually calmed down the ammonia burn, which is good news. Rectified spirit, of which we need 1 1/2 ounces, just in time to burn our sinuses again. And finally, we need 18 ounces of distilled water. 16. Mix the ingredients and let them stand for 1 week, stirring frequently. and filter. This smells not the worst. In a weird way, it smells kind of sweet, but also very potently chemically. You can definitely smell the rose oil, and I think that's what's giving it that nice, sweet smell, along with 95% alcohol, as well as ammonia. So it is this weird, like, delicate Victorian chemicals. It is very purple. It will be an actual miracle if this does not dye my hair purple. This needs to now be set and rested for a week. While that sets over the next week, I'll take a moment in the intro to tell you about our very necessary sponsor for today's experiments, Blue Land. EPA certified purveyors of hand soaps and cools, which are environmentally conscious and sourced from clean ingredients. Which is most fortuitous because with potion making tomfoolery always comes no shortage of messes to clean. Unlike traditional liquid cleaners that are sold in single-use plastic containers, Blue Land tablets dissolve in minutes in reusable bottles, eliminating the need for single-use plastics in everything from packaging to wrappers to shipping. Their products are vegan and cruelty-free and are sourced from ingredients without parabens, chlorine bleach, VOC, soy and nut, and, most gratefully, ammonia, which my respiratory system has had quite enough of at the moment. I got the hand soap duo, which includes an array of every tablet flavor imaginable, which came in particularly useful in later dyeing shenanigans. Might I just say that the sweet aroma of bergamot rose lends a certain glamour to those iron sulfate stains. Follow the link below and use my code to get an exclusive 20% off your first order to try out Blue Land for yourself. And now, with clean surfaces and hands, let's check in on our curling fluid. Good morning. Some time has passed. Our little potion here is looking kind of gross, but this is going to get strained and all finished up in just a minute. Before we get started with that, though, I'm going to head over to the hob because one of our next recipes involves rose water. So that's going to take a couple of minutes to boil and simmer. So let's get that started, and then we'll come back to here, and then we'll make the other two recipes. Now for 20 minutes, and in the meanwhile, we are going to go ahead and finish up this recipe. All that really needs to happen with this is that this needs to be strained through a cheesecloth or a muslin cloth just to get rid of these particles so you have a nice, clean liquid.
Seriously, like, not put any freaking gravy on anything. Okay. Whatever. I don't have a microwave, so.
This recipe states that the intention is to keep the hair in curl for a definite period of time, especially in damp weather. So basically, this one is for hairspray. However, this does go on to warn that these preparations, owing to their gummy character, should not be used very frequently as they tend to harden and dry the hair and cause it to crack and break in combing. So, not a recipe to be used with great frequency. However, this recipe will supposedly hold your curls in place. The three ingredients that we need for this are rose water, we need gum tragacanth, which is basically a glue, oil of sweet almond. So the first step, it says, is to break up the gum tragacanth into small pieces. They are quite small already, but I'm going to go ahead and just crush them up a little bit more. I don't think they want them to be
the driest fucking jerky in the world. Seriously, Mom? You give me Thanksgiving leftovers? You don't even give me any freaking gravy.
Really help us at all,
what jerky want gravy on Thanksgiving? Choking. That's what it is. Choking.
Added to the rose water. Allowed to stand in a warm place and shake occasionally until the gum is softened throughout. Well, luckily for us, our rose water is still a little bit warm because it's just come off the stove. It doesn't give us a time as to how much time we're supposed to be allowing our gum for the scent to stand. Let's say long enough until it is softened throughout, making a jelly-like mass. I wonder how long allowed to stand is, because it's been 15 minutes and we are not achieving a jelly-like mass quite yet. Well, I suppose this means allowed to stand while one goes and has one. Then we will check back in and see what the situation is. Right. Oh, this is what they meant by one big gelatinous mass. And this is about an hour and a half later. The gum tragosand gets filtered out, leaving just the fluid. So the final ingredient is we need half a dram of this sweet almond oil. The final step is to mix thoroughly. I don't know precisely what they mean by thoroughly, granted that this is oil. It's behaving very oily, which means it will forever be separated slightly from the water. We will give this as thorough mix as we can possibly manage. There's something. It does have a nice color. It does smell relatively nice, like rose water, but I'm a bit confused about the oil, what this is supposed to be doing. I wonder if the oil is meant to give it, like, shine and finish, because this does feel very greasy, but I suppose the answer to that question will be determined in the experimentation phase. Many persons dissatisfied with the color nature has bestowed upon their locks resort to dyes to produce whatever hue may happen to please their fancy. And though the writer has no sympathy whatsoever with this course, and sincerely believes that nature's arrangement of the coloring of the hair, eyes, and complexion is rarely improved by the interference of art, in defense to the wishes of those who desire to use such recipes, the following are given. The shade. Well, let us have a look at our ingredients list. The first is green sulfates of iron, which nowadays is often used for solar conditioning, common salt, Bordeaux wine. We will also, in a later stage of this process, need nut galls, which come from oak trees, which have actually frequently been used in black dyes and ink, and have been used for many centuries. Finally, we will need some French brandy. 2 grams of green sulfate of iron. Well, this smells exactly as you would expect the sulfate to smell. So here's what I'm thinking is happening, is that this iron sulfide is oxidizing on my hands and is turning my hands a suspicious grayish color. As mildly disconcerting as is for my hands, I do think this bodes well for the function of a hair dye. Okay, so the final ingredient we have for this first round is Bordeaux wine, and 12 fluid ounces of this. This is not the way this is supposed to be done. Oh no. Disaster has stricken. Not that we couldn't have all seen this coming, but 12 fluid ounces of wine. So these ingredients now need to simmer together in this glazed pipkin for 5 minutes. To the hob once again.
So my hob does this thing where it won't heat unless the thing covers the thing entirely. Makes sense from a safety point of view, but not from a Victorian pipkin point of view.
So while that gets up to heat, which will take a minute, I'm going to get started crushing up some of these oak balls, which we need 2 grams of. This will then get added to the simmering mixture over there, and then continue to simmer for a bit.
So stupid. Okay. So I think
think the reason why they specify glazed them in heavy italics in this recipe is because that glaze will help to keep the sides of it completely there. Down a little bit, it's still slightly warm. So the final step in this recipe process is to add this to a bottle.
No!
It's not going very well at all. And to this we're going to add 1 tablespoon of French brandy. This now gets corked, shaken, and this now gets let to stand for 2 days, wherein hypothetically, this will separate into some clear and some not clear mixture. We'll see what happens. Before we get started with washing and dyeing experiments, we're first going to need some hair. And fortunately, I need a little trim. This is a sample on which I will test the dye, since I'm rather suspicious of Victorian dyes.
I should have cut the front of your hair. Why, it's green!
This book gives a very similar recipe for cleansing the hair as the one demonstrated in my Edwardian hair care video of yore, but roughly involves 1 egg yolk mixed into 1 pint of warm water with 1 ounce of rosemary spirit. Rosemary spirit seems to be the one ingredient during the course of this entire experiment that does not seem to be available today, so I mixed 1/2 ounce of rosemary oil with 1/2 ounce of the plain rectified spirit, which may or may not have been A, how this was actually done historically, and B, a wise decision for using so close to the face. We'll get to that later.
Before using any of the liquids, you need to thoroughly cleanse the hair from dust and grease by washing it with hot water containing a pinch of soda or 4 ounces, drying perfectly before applying the dye. There is also a note in this text that says for hair washing should not be done oftener than once a week. This entire bathroom smells like it is intoxicating the rosemary.
Yeah, I'm afraid that's not just rosemary oil.
I don't know if I should do this again, but here we go. I'm clean now. Now we just wait for this to dry. We'll see that in a couple of hours.
Washing your hair with a 95% alcohol solution with your head tipped forward as you are straight up inhaling said 95% alcohol solution. Well, my hair isn't yet dry, but our sample hair is dry, so we can go ahead and experiment with the hair dye on this. I mean, it's looking pretty potent. However, the instructions do say that there should have been a separation with a clear liquid, but that has not happened. So I'm not sure what this is all about, but I suppose let's go ahead and see if it works. My hypothesis is that it will still work, considering that it was dyeing my hands, and it has got that iron sulfate in it, so it should do something. This smells so strongly of wine, I have no tolerance for this right now. I'm just going to sit in here for a couple of minutes. I'm not expecting it to immediately look distinctly different, but given the oxidization properties of the iron, I'm expecting that it will probably take a couple of minutes to develop once it's been taken out of this mixture. I'm also not going to rinse this, since a lot of Victorian hair dyes are not water fast, or at least they don't last more than a couple of washes, or even 1 wash at all. The main reason being, of course, that people weren't washing their hair quite frequently. I would guess that this would just been used and then dried and then just brushed through, but not actually washed. But this would have been reapplied when you rewash your hair and it starts to fade. It does look like it's starting to do something. I can't tell whether this is just being hair being dark because it's wet, or if it actually is starting to do something. I guess I will just have to be patient and wait for this to actually properly dry, but I'm hopeful. So we are all dry. As you can see, the dye did have an effect. It did dye the hair black, which I'm not sure was the initial intent, but it did, as the instructions say, darken the hair. I do rather like my original hair color better, so I will not be using this on my real actual hair. It is very powdery and filmy, like you can still feel it. It feels like there's definitely a residue on it. My next question is this wash safe? Does this just wash straight out in the water, or does it stay in permanently? Post-wash and one dry, here we have our hair sample. As you can see, it has lightened slightly, but it hasn't quite lightened completely. So I imagine that this dye would come off eventually after probably 2 or 3 washes, but it's just, you know, not the worst. So I'm not 1,000% confident in how this curling lotion, as they call it, in how this worked. I guess we'll find out, because this is the point of the experiment. But it does say in the instructions to wet the hair while dressing, and then as the lotion dries, the curl will take effect. I don't know if that means that this liquid alone is going to be responsible for making the hair just spring into a curl. My hair still reeks of rosemary and alcohol, by the way. Not only my hair, but the entire workroom. My hair also feels weirdly sticky. Like, it's been drying for about 7 hours now, and it still feels a little bit damp, which leads me to believe it's not water, but it's some combination of oil and alcohol and egg. Makes sense, because it was precisely what I adulterated my hair with. I'm first just separating that front section of hair, which will be put into round curls and set overnight. This first side here will be dampened with acrylic glue just before setting, while the other side will be dampened just water before setting. This way I can maybe get a sense of whether or not the curly fluid makes any difference in the curls that have been set. My goal is to try and make these red curls quite tight because the 1880s up to about 1889, the hairstyle is very loopy and frizzy at front. The hair is probably a lot shorter than mine is, but I'm trying to go with as tight a curl as possible so that I can hopefully turn it up a little bit, hide some of the length of it under some pins, and get away with something relatively 1889. I do really wish the Victorians would stop putting so much strong scent into all these products, because my sensory system is quite overwhelmed with all of the rose oil and the olive oil and the rosemary, and they're not subtle. They're very potent. When you're putting this many products in your hair, it's not the most ideal sensory experience. And now, finally, I'm just going to dampen the ends of my other hair with this stuff, let this dry, just to see if, like the instructions seem to imply, if when this dries in the hair, it curls the hair without doing all this nonsense. So, we shall see the results tomorrow. So here's the verdict on the curl situation. As you can see, this is the end of the hair that I just dipped into the solution last night and then just let to dry. I'm genuinely surprised that it did actually do something. It did actually put a bit of wave into my hair. Admittedly, I only dipped a little portion of it last night, and I was actually really shocked that it like sprang up into an actual curl. So I got excited and I did the whole end of it, but I guess because it's heavier and it clumped together a little bit more, it didn't have as much of an effect here. As you can see, it's just more of a wave. So I think the way that you're supposed to do this is kind of combining the application of this lotion with a sort of like curly girl method handling of the hair, where you have to kind of make sure that it's drying in a position that you want it to, and that it will kind of stay. In regards to these set curls, I don't think was meant as the application for this, but I will say it made a little bit of difference. This side of hair definitely came out a little bit crispier, As I was removing the rags, this side was very difficult to remove because the hair was very much like clinging onto its shape. This side, however, was very easy to remove, but the hair was not as clinging to the rag. These curls are a little bit softer, they're a little bit frizzier, they're a little bit less like in nice crisp shape. These are a lot less frizzy and a lot more just compact. So let's see what we can do in terms of 1889 hairstyling. So here's what we have so far. I realize this experiment is at a distinct disadvantage because I'm not accustomed to doing 1889 hairstyles and therefore I don't have that skill of repetition that would make this a little bit more realistic. I do have a little bit too much fluff here at the front, but there's not really anything I can do about that. The curl on this side is a little bit tighter and a little bit more sculptable than the curls that were just held by water. It's not noticeable really at all, I don't think. So I don't think a potion like this is necessary to achieve the quintessential perfect 19th century curl, but I do think it helped, definitely. So those who were ambitious enough to put in the time and the labor to be making that, apply it, set it, etc., would have got slightly crispier results, perhaps. Now, the final question we have in this hairstyling endeavor is whether or not our hairspray works. Calling this hairspray is kind of a misnomer. It is not spraying into the hair. It would have just been applied to the fingers gently like this and just patted into the hair. The hair spray, in quotes, is kind of okay, given that I've got the recipe right, which is not guaranteed. I didn't actually find it to be very strong, despite the warnings of breakage in the recipe. So if it's not strong and damaging, then I'm not really sure what the point of it is. If I've nearly done the recipe wrong, which I suspect may have been around the almond oil stage, since the liquid did feel more oily than sticky, I'm not sure if our sweet almond oil is the same as what's called for in the recipe of the 19th century, but in that case, it's possible that this is supposed to be strong and would only have been used for special occasions. The other two recipes I was actually quite impressed with. While the curling fluid didn't have dramatic effects, it still did do interesting textural and wavy things that I will most definitely be unironically continuing to experiment with in my 21st century existence. The dye, whilst not exactly relevant to my personal needs, did still work and survived a wash even, which is pretty impressive for a 19th century hair dye. As I was working out the recipes, the one thing that I really noticed is A, the amount of time that each of these items took to prepare, and B, how many ingredients went into some of these items. This video itself took me weeks to prepare for, simply because I had to source all of the ingredients, find all the items, buy all the items, and I have access to the internet. I can just go online and search for things like potassium carbonate and rectified spirit. I do have a sense that a lot of these items could be found more easily by going to an apothecary or the local grocer or the general store. There is definitely the element of the time it takes to acquire all of these ingredients, as well as the cost it takes to obtain all of these ingredients, as well as, of course, the time it takes to prepare the recipes themselves. So I started to ask the question, would these things be worth doing? These household guides in general tends to be written more towards a middle class readership, towards women who don't have a full repertoire of domestic staff or any domestic staff at all, but who also might have a little bit of spare time and a little bit of spare cash. They provide a way for people to keep up with fashionable trends and regular practices of the household without having to hire staff to do that or to have been brought up in an environment where they would have been taught this stuff. So I hope you enjoyed today's shenanigans. I will be back anon with some more dress history, experimental archaeology, all sorts of excitement.
I have on this most auspicious day stumbled upon a beauty handbook from the year
1911. So naturally, I now have no choice but to get up and do some.
Alright, so like, as far as all that was concerned, I had no idea this lady actually does these things.
Ever that, actually. These seam allowances are trimmed down to 3. I did initially put this on the mannequin and I was like, oh my god, this is all wrong, it doesn't come up this high, why is this gaping? But then I realized that I did not pre-shape the bones for this mock-up on the actual bust bodice. It does curve out a lot more like this, which puts the top of it in a much better position and also helps the top of it sit flatter against the chest. Because these are flat steel bones, they can be bent into shape, and that's what I would be doing before I put these into bony channels on the actual thing. So that's where we are so far, just mock-upping. It seems to be working fine. I'm ready now to get started on the bobbinet version of this. By the way, excuse this absolutely hideous stitching, but you know what? Machines are not my jam. So before we can get started on cutting out the bobbinet, we first have to put some starch into this because the original bust bodice is very, very stiff. I have here some potato starch. I mean, in the Victorian period, they probably would have had actual purpose laundry starch, but I couldn't find any in the grocery store that wasn't, like, spray bottle starch that includes, like, chemicals and silicone and stuff, so I decided I'm going to go the natural route. I have some water boiling over there, getting ready to help us with this endeavor, and I also have my notes on starching from when I actually learned how to do this in 2018. I've since forgotten how to do this. But we are going to see if we can re-remind ourselves how this works. It is a very delicate balance, all of this starching stuff. There's some serious chemistry, I guess, that has to go on, because in order for the starch to get...
Okay, so I have a question for you guys. Do you hear the noise? Is it really bad? Hey! Are you still around? I have no idea what you missed. I know what I missed. But anyway, as far as what's going on back here, you guys are going to see that soon. I'm going to probably spend another, I don't know, maybe 6-7 minutes. Maybe 6 or 7 minutes. Is watching more YouTube, whatever. Then after, so I'm gonna start my, I guess, like comedy routine. Not so sure about that. Not so sure about my comedy routine for real. But as I digress, I don't know why I only have one viewer. I mean, I guess it's the same thing as like on YouTube. You gotta like. Hey, or be an affiliate. So I don't know exactly how you be an affiliate when maybe there's just too many people. Just too many people on Twitch. So everybody else is like watching someone else. Maybe that's it. Yeah. Okay, so I should probably put it right there instead. Cool. As I was saying, I don't really like this setup, do I? Oops. What is this? That's not what I wanted. Excuse me. It gets worse. As time goes by, so slowly. Supposedly a blank seam. I don't like Pokemon Go. Where did I go on this side? Find myself. Where did I go? Where am I? Do you see me? Aha! I have appeared. Cool beans. Anyway. Because you probably just want to see me, so... Okay. Left hand, right hand. Boogie, boogie, boogie. Okay, it works. Cool. Alright, so I guess I'll just be playing Diablo. I don't really feel like all that other nonsense today. So, is the noise there, Daniel, or not? Where did it go?
That's stupid. Okay, I hate it when stuff just disappears like that. Inherently, it's kind of dumb. What? It's not even showing up. There we go. It's slowly done. It just like timed out over there. Yep. Super cool, and then I want my chat box, which for some dumb reason isn't working right now. Which kind of doesn't matter because nobody's really ever talking to me. Say something. Hello? Is anybody out there? Hello? Okay, marking onward. I don't even know why I even stream anymore. It just seems like nobody's watching. You know, just keep playing until somebody comes. I'll eventually come. Build it and they will come, they say. Dude, there's so many unnecessary things in here. Ugh, okay. How do I make space for things? Like this, like why do I have this? Does anybody remember what that's even for anymore? Anybody remember? So drab. How do I both of these? This 12 and this 10. Suppose we can get rid of this guy. Thank you.
wasted a lot of time getting to this point. Sure where I'm supposed to go. small shoe. Go get it! Dumb bitch. Oh! Alright. There's some language, lady. Where's your language, lady?
Unidentified.
Unidentified. Flying penis. I don't think that would be really great. Like, what would you do with an unidentified flying penis? Well, you know what? Let's get that. There we go, y'all. I really don't like how there's like a whole bunch of empty space like next to my face.
Nice and centered. Beautiful.
All the way down here, camera. All the way down here. So, there's another visual here. Visual. Individual. Has anybody ever started talking about anything yet? No. Silence in my chat room. Silence. I'm not silencing you. I'm just making fun of how silent it is. Am I trapped? Oh. That's interesting. How the F do I get down from here? The stamina shrine! Doing that.
Has anybody ever told me, like, is there a noise? Like, what's going on with my mic? Somebody never told me, then I'm not telling you what's going on with it. Like, can you hear me okay? Or, okay? Can you hear me okay? I don't know. Alright, that's good. Alright, so what did I get about? Okay. So I have fixed it, I think. Hello. I suppose this can go there. I might need these, I'm not sure. I rarely ever use them. Thank you kindly. How about this thing? Why am I not wearing that? Thank you. Alright, so going back. Why the fire, you say? Because I like it. Alright, so is there anything else that was worth me picking up? I couldn't find where I was supposed to be going. I went up there. I think it ends over there. Let me see what's over here. I finish all this area? Okay. Not sure. So it's in the Lost City, and then is this going backwards or forwards? I can't tell. Far away
answers. Okay, so I'm going backwards? How am I supposed to go forwards? So back to the Lost City, but where do I go from here? I am going to do Just Dance soon, by the way. So if you don't like Just Dance, then you can flee from the situation. I have no idea where I'm supposed to be going. Supposed to be going here? I feel like I'm missing something. Alright, anyway. Maybe there's more over here? Oh yeah, there's definitely more over here. Seems more useful than that for now. Okay, I'm not sure. But I think there's more over here somewhere. I have no idea where I'm supposed to go right now. Like, this seems to be the end. And up here, it looks like it's supposed to go somewhere, but it doesn't. So I don't know where I'm supposed to go right now.
Actually, where is Talamish's grave? Probably somewhere. Probably in the... I'm not sure. I'm gonna end with this with me going to the palace. What do you think? Like big black dots on my thing, you know. I don't know. I hate the program I'm using. It just sucks. Mother, get me out of here. Am I gonna, like, reach any monsters soon? So far, so bad. Where is everybody? I want to go kill something now. Oh, they're there. I spoke too soon. Music is in fact Diablo 2 music, by the way. In case you're wondering why. Where is it? Ooh, a jewel. I don't even use those very much. But yeah, this is where I'm going to be ending this. Feel free to comment about that. I know you want to. One! Fantastic. Alright, everyone. This was my Just Dance thing. I might just make a new one, because nobody can see anything, and I don't know why. Like, you literally cannot see anything. So let me go ahead and make a gameplay one. Standardized gameplay. Oops, where am I? There I am. There I am! Wonderful. I kind of like that. Yep. That doesn't bother me. What bothers me is... your face. Alright, so let me see how this looks on cam.
Alright, so I'm gonna set up Victor's chaos. Y'all sit pretty, Teddy. Cool beans. Already unplugged here. Oh, I know why. Okay, so this is already plugged in there. The game capture is supposed to come. From the actual game itself. I'm not sure what's going on here. Wait, so if this is in and that's out. Okay, guys. They go to sleep on me again? Why is it happening to me? Go. Alright, I'm not sure. Guys. It's a little too close. Can you see my head?
like...
Bye.
this game, man. What do you think?
Oh,
so
enjoyed that.